Welcome to the channel. In this video, we will talk about random numbers in C programming language. We will see how we can generate random numbers. Then we will talk about providing seed for the random number generator. And then we will talk about how we can make sure that for every run, we get different sequence of random numbers. Now here I have written a simple program. I have included stdio.h header file, and then we have this main function. Just like any other programming language, C language also provides some built-in library functions for generating random numbers. Now, in order to use that library function, we need to include the header file stdlib standardlibrary.h. So I'm going to do that first. It will be stdlib.h. Now the function that is used for generating the random number is called as rand. This function generates a random number between 0 and the value which is defined in a macro called as rand max. Now first let us see that range. So I'm going to use the printf function in here. Here we're going to display %d to %d, and we know that the lower value of that range, which is 0, and the maximum value is defined in a macro called as rand underscore max. So when you type it, you know, you get that. Now if I run this program, you guys can see we get 0 to 32,767. Now this value may depend on the tool set that you're using and the system that you're using. Let us use the rand function and let's generate some random numbers. So I'm going to use the printf function, and here we will display the random numbers printed %d, and we will display more than one number. So I'm gonna insert a new line after displaying the number, and here we will directly call that number. You know, if you want, we can call this function, store that random number generated in a variable, and then we can refer that variable, but I don't want to do that. I'm gonna directly refer that here, and to use this function we just have to type in rand, and that's it. Now if I run this program, it will generate one random number. Let's copy and paste this code multiple times. Now if I run this program, then you guys can see we get four random numbers here. First number is 41, second number is 18,467, then 6,334, and 26,500. Now here this rand function generates a pseudo random integer number between 0 and the rand max. Whenever we call this rand function, an algorithm is used, and that algorithm returns a non-related number. And that's why the numbers generated are not linked in any way, they are random. Now here, I'm gonna run this program one more time, and you guys can see the numbers generated, they are not related in any way. But now, I'm gonna close this, I'm gonna run this program again, and we will compare the results of previous two runs. Now this was the run which I did before, and this is the current run. Now if you look at the sequence of random numbers generated, then they are same. So the first number is 41 in both cases, second number is 18,467, third and fourth number also same. When you run the program, no matter how many times you use this rand function, you get a non-related number, a random number. But for that multiple runs, that random sequence is same. For example, here, now I have the result of three runs, and you guys can see this sequence is same. Now let us talk about why we get this same sequence for multiple runs. Now the algorithm that is used for generating the random number uses a variable, and that variable's value defines the sequence of random number generated. So what we do here is we will construct our own algorithm, just a simple algorithm for generating the random number. Now whenever we talk about generating a number, you know, we need to have a starting point. Now let us say the algorithm that we are writing will have a variable, and let us initialize this variable with a value of 1. I'm going to call this variable as initializer, and I will initialize this with a value of 1. Now let us define the logic for generating the random number. Let us say if the program requests our algorithm for the first random number, then the logic may be like n equal to I plus, let us say, 2. This is for the first random number. If the program requests for another random number, then what we do is we will make n equal to n plus 3. And if we get the request for another random number, then we will perform n equal to n minus 2. Then n equal to n multiplied by 2. This probably be the worst algorithm for generating the random number, but for understanding why we get the same sequence of random numbers for multiple runs, I think this is enough. Now let us say our program uses our algorithm for generating the random number. So this initializer variable is set with a value of 1. So when the program requests for the first random number, our program will return 3. Because I is 1, 1 plus 2 is equal to 3, and that 3 will be stored in this n variable, and it will be stored internally by our algorithm, let us say that, this I and n variables value. And then the program requests for another random number. So now n is 3, so 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. Now the program requests for another random number, so it will be 6 minus 2, 4. And then again happens, so it will be 8. Because 4 multiplied by 2 is 8. Now, if you continue this logic, in whatever the way, then these numbers are not related in any way. So these are random numbers. Now, the program will be terminated. And then the user again launches the program. What happens at that time? Now, again, the I variable is initialized with a value of 1. And the program requests our algorithm for a random number. So I is 1. And when the program requests for the first random number, it will be I plus 2, which will be equal to 1 plus 2, 3. And then if the program requests for another random number, it will be 3 plus 3, 6. And then if it requests for another random number, it will be 4. And then it will be 8, and like that. Now, if the user looks at the output, then for 2 runs, he gets the same sequence of random numbers. Now, if you look at this logic, then the same sequence of random numbers are generated because of this I value. Here, our algorithm that we have written, it depends on this I variable's value. So if we change the value of this I variable, then the random numbers will be different. So if we can change the I variable's value here, then the random number produced for multiple runs will be different values. For example, let us say I is 2. So what happens? For the first random number, it will be 2 plus 2, which will be 4. And then 4 plus 3, which will be 7. Then 7 minus 2, which will be 5. Then 5 into 2, which will be 10. Again, if the user changes the I variable's value for another run, for example, if we make is 10, then the sequence of random numbers generated will be different. So the algorithm used here depends on a variable's value. If it is set to a default value, then the sequence of random numbers generated will be same for multiple runs. Same thing is happening here in this program. The algorithm used by this rand function for generating the random number depends on a value that is used by the algorithm. And since we have not set that value here, it is set to the default value. Default value is 1. And that's why the sequence generated by this rand function for multiple runs is same. Now, the C programming language allows us to change that value. We can initialize the value used by the random number generator algorithm. And we can do that by using a function called as srand. And we just need to call this function and we need to provide the value. The default value is 1. So if I write in 1 here, then it should not make any difference. It should produce the same result which it has produced before. So if I run this, then you guys can see we get the same numbers here. Okay. Now I'm going to clear this. Now I'm going to change this value. Now this value, which will be used to initialize the random number generator, is called as seed. Now I'm going to change this seed to 10. Now, if I save this program and if I run this code, then you guys can see the random number generated or the sequence of random numbers generated are different. So in the previous run, when we set the seed as 1, we got the first number as 41, but now we got 71. Now here, again, if I don't change this seed value, then we get the same sequence of random numbers. So here, if I want the program to generate different sequence of random numbers for different runs, then I need to change the value, or I need to change this seed value. So the problem here is we can't directly specify that value here in the code, because if you do that, then it will be the same value for whatever the number of times the user is going to run the program. So what we have to do is we have to find a way to get a number which will be different all the time. And one such value is time. In C programming language, there is a function available and it is called as time, and it returns the number of seconds elapsed since 1970 January 1. So it will change for every second. So if we can get that value and if we can pass that as seed to this srand function, then for every run, the program will generate different sequence of random numbers. So to do that, we need to include another header file, and it is called as time.h. And the function that returns the number of seconds elapsed since 1970 January 1 is called as time. And as a parameter, we can pass null here. The parameter will be a timer, and we don't want that here in this program. So we just want to pass null. This time function will return the number of seconds elapsed since 1970 January 1, and that value will change for every second, and that value will be used as seed for the random number generator algorithm. And that's why whenever we run this program, for every run we get different random numbers. I'm gonna save this program and I'm gonna run this. Okay, now you guys can see we got these numbers. I'm gonna close it. I'm gonna run it. Now we got these numbers. So now here, the sequence of random numbers generated will be different for different runs. So now we can say that the program is producing somewhat better random numbers. So in the next video, we will see how we can generate the random numbers within a range of values. For example, random numbers between 0 and 10, or random numbers between 0 and 100, and like that. Now, if you like the content, then hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you want to say something, then write that in the comment box. For more tutorials like this, do subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next video.